Hi, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the second episode to create a WordPress website using our own custom theme. In the previous episode, we worked on installing WordPress, theme creation and importing Google Font and Font Awesome in header.php. Today, we'll be working on header and popular plugin called Custom Post Type UI. First of all, let's remove this tagline. So go to the admin panel, go to the setting, general. Then you can simply remove this tagline, save. Then let's add container div in header.php so that it comes at center with some max width. Open your WP content, theme, finance, header.php. And then you can just add container div over here. Refresh, and it's coming at the center now. Now, according to the design, we don't need this search and its model, so let's remove them. Open your header.php, and if you go all the way to the bottom, the model is coming from this code. So remove this one, and now if you refresh the site again and click on this search icon, you will not see the model. Also, if you want to remove this icon, you have to open header.php and remove this if condition. Now if you refresh the site, the search icon is gone. You should see there is one more if condition that says something like expanded menu. What this means is, if you use this menu, even in desktop version, you would see something like this kind of menu. But for the time being, in desktop version, I'm good to go with this simple menu, so I can remove this code too. Remember, I'm removing unwanted code because I want clean and simple code. If you want to use any of them in the future, then you can always get them from our 2020 theme. Now let's add this contact detail, but before that, let's add a new plugin called Custom Post Type UI. So open your admin panel, go to plugin, add new. Then here you can search custom post type UI, enter. Click on install now. Click on activate. Then you are redirected to this installed plugin section. So here you can see a list of plugin that you have used for this site. You can always activate or deactivate or remove plugin from this section. Now let's create a new post type for contact details. So hover on this CPT UI, which is custom post type UI, and then click on add or edit post types. Then you can add all this information. I will write contact underscore details. I will write contact detail over here, and I will add same name over here. Then if you go all the way to the bottom, you can choose what option you want to show in that post. So I'll use title and custom field, and I will remove editor and feature image. So once done, I can just click on this add post type. So now you should see that there is a separate contact detail created over here, so you can click on them and then click on add new to create new. Then you can add a title over here. I'll just say contact details. Then we need phone number and email address, so I will use custom field in that case. So I will write call us over here, and then add the phone number over here. Once done, you can click on this add custom field, and the next thing we need is email. So I will write email and then copy the email address. Once done, you can click on add custom field and you can publish the changes. All the admin panel configuration is done. Now it's time to show this data using code in header.php. So first let's add new div called contact info just after the end of header title wrapper. Then inside this code, I will just add this code. It means get all the data from custom post type UI. Remember, this name should match exactly to the post type slug, which is this one. It should always match to this name. Now, among that post, we only need to show this two custom field, so I will add another code over here. Here I have created a variable and used get post meta function to get data from call us. This should match exactly to this name over here. Then I'm just showing data inside this li with some class name. Now if you refresh the site, both contact and email is showing now. Now the last thing I want to do is to fix this styling issue. So I will move this navigation div outside of this header inner div. So this is the navigation div, which starts with header navigation wrapper. So I will just cut this div and paste it outside this header inner div. And also, I just want to remove this class name, and instead I want to add ID called main nav. Now refresh the site and your design should look exactly to our original design over here. Finally, if you want to remove this admin bar, then go to the admin panel, go to the user, click all user, click on admin, and then uncheck this toolbar. Click on update profile, and now if you refresh the site again, then you should no longer see the toolbar. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, I will show you how to create pages and work in our main menu. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.